are dead. Just looking at myself in the viewfinder, I'm like, wow. Anywho, hello. I feel like I'm way too close to the camera. Even though I'm like really far back, I'm trying to make the background less icky, which is difficult because I share a room with my little sister and it's just difficult. Sister, ugh, I'm really tired. I'm not. It's just a thing, an English thing that people say. You know, I'm really tired because you don't want to talk about your feelings. Oh, sorry. I'm just like thinking about the English, how are you? And how everyone's just like, how are you? And you have to reply that you're okay. It's just a thing. Anyway, I'm in a good mood. So, debuting my short hair. Hello. 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 I want to talk about happy things and 2018 because I actually didn't get a lot of chance. Listen, life is difficult. I can't speak freaking two languages fluently. I love myself sometimes. Just where's my book? Okay, this is one of my many happy books. This is my rainbow one. I did introduce it. I just remembered something that I really have to, like, do something about. Anyway, so basically, this year, a lot of things are happening in sense of, like, this is, like, the transitional year. This is the year that I don't have to worry too much because, you know, I'm not going anywhere this year. I know where I am this year, unless I suddenly, like, I don't know, get expelled from school, but I'm not gonna make that happen. I know where I am. I know what I'll be doing. So on, so on. And so it's kind of like a pretty stable year. So I've got my resolutions written down. And there's a lot of them. Oh my god, how did I write that down? That's absolutely insane. Go really fast. Appreciation. Self-appreciation. Like my posts. Like what I'm wearing. You know, just kind of appreciate what I'm doing with my life. Because I don't like the trend of hating yourself constantly. Because that's shit. Songs. I literally wrote LOL next to it. Because let's be real, I will never put out my songs. Like it's going to take me a while. I mean, to be fair, I've got them planned. And if I have time, I'm going to sit down and make them. But anyway, do I have cooking written down? Because if not, cooking. That's the thing. I'm cooking. Like, I'm literally going to go and make casserole in, like, 20 minutes. Me and my watch that I definitely have on my hand. YouTube. Hello. Be open. Yeah! No! Latvia. Oh yeah, I plan to go to Latvia, if that actually works. Because Pat lives there. And I want to meet Pat, finally. Health. Health? Health. Heath. That says Heath. Health. Yeah. Gary, take care of yourself. Good thing. I put some kind of unrealistic Instagram goal of like 4,000 followers, which is unrealistic. But I always make them unrealistic, and I hit 1,000, which was unrealistic for me last year, and I hit it, and I've got 100 more, so we don't know. We'll see. Future. Oh yeah, like future plans. Well, yeah, it's kind of like basically exploring my photography, making my portfolio. I think I've got portfolio written down there somewhere as well. So on, so on. Mum. Oh yeah, I really want to help my mum out this year. I mean, I always want to help my mum out. Like, I think that's kind of like the main thing. I want money to help my mum out. It's like, it's always been that way, and I don't think it's never gonna not be that way. Like, literally, if I ever get a massive photography project, the first thing I'm gonna do is, like, give mum money. Literally, it's just the way it is. Spanish into French. Yeah, I kind of want to start learning French next year because I know that I'm gonna need it, probably. I mean, I'm gonna need it in my life anyway, but... Korean vocab and Korean in general. Doing that, literally joined like this kind of this app where you can talk to people who are fluent in the language, and I'm talking to some people from Korea, and I'm just like, yes, please, Ratatouille. Lol. I've been planning to make Ratatouille for around 5 years. Still haven't. Love projects. Yeah, I'm starting my personal project from photography soon, and I'm very excited, and it's gonna be about love. And I'm a cheesy little shit, so obviously it's gonna be about love. Bike. Okay, technically I have a bike, but I almost died on it yesterday. I kind of have like a very blurred remember? I have a blurred memory of it now, but it was terrifying. I literally thought this is how I die, but no, I didn't. Did I not write ice skating down? Kelly, what the fuck are you doing with your life? Explore. Oh yeah, like I really want to go to London again. I just don't have any money. But when I have money, I'm going to go to London, stay with my aunt, explore around London, talk to aunt, blah, blah, blah. Pride. Duh. We all know that. Come on. Brighton. Really want to go to Brighton by myself or with like a friend or two because fuck, I love Brighton. Peak District. Peak District is this national park in central England that the Mini Countryman ad was filmed in, and it's like the most surreal place on photos anyway, and I really, really want to go. I'm trying to like urge my dad to get there, like to go there like on a family trip with me and family, but we'll see. Drawing. I started drawing again. That's the thing. There. Look at that. Oh shit. It's very bad, but I try. Anywho. Right. Writing. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. I started writing again. Kind of. I mean, yeah, I have to write on my English reset. However, I've also kind of started having script and book ideas, so something's going. We'll see. Read every day. I'm trying. Listen, when your roommate goes to sleep at 8 p.m, then it's kind of hard to read, because I always read at night. Like, that was my thing that I've done since I was like 7, when I started reading books. That's why my eyesight's so shit. I would always read at night with really bad lighting, or just like use a torch and be like under my bed. But yeah, this is why I have such shit eyesight, and now I can't do that, so I have to have the light on, but I can't have the light on because Vicky's asleep, and it's just like, anyway, that's cool. Those are my resolutions, right? I think, it's really difficult talking about it, because already, like, in the past 2 weeks almost, of 2018, that passed, like, so many things have happened. Like, I've rebranded my channel completely. I've rebranded my life. Like, I'm working under Rosestart now, which is surreal for me, because Rosestart has always been like this kind of fantasy and alternate universe where I would, you know, escape and be my true self and shit, and it was always something really secretive, and I never really thought about it much, because it was like my own little universe. And suddenly I was like, hey, I'm gonna rebrand to Rosestart, or hey, I should probably change my YouTube channel name, and I changed it to Rosestart, and suddenly it didn't feel right. Not gonna lie, it didn't feel right. I felt like I was disturbing the peace and quiet of my alternate universe. However, now, like, even my main Instagram account is called Rosestart. I changed it from my actual name to Rosestart, and I think, like, usually it's the other way around. I'm messing with the system a lot, and to be fair, I'm finding it quite interesting. but a lot of things are going on. And it's really exciting. It's really scary, but it's really exciting. And I've got some photo shoots planned. And I did a photo shoot now with Lucas that was just absolutely incredible. And I keep dying over these photos, because I didn't even know that they were that good, generally because my head was in so much pain that I had no time to process each photo. I just kind of looked at them and I was like, yeah, I think that's good. I think it's in focus. Let's carry on. And then I came home and I literally fell asleep straight away because I was in so much pain. And then throughout the next couple of days, I kind of realised that the photos were really, really good. And I was proud of myself and proud of Lucas for going and doing the weird photos that I do. Because I think it's really funny. Like, I'm still not used to, like, people giving me compliments. Like Gabby, shout out. A couple of days ago, I gained 200 followers on my Instagram account. And for me, that was just kind of like refresh. Oh my god, more people. No, it's really weird, but I enjoy the fact that people enjoy my photography. I think that's kind of a normal thing for an artist. However, I still kind of feel like, oh my god, this is the stuff that I make, the stuff that I do, that I feel so proud of, that are going out into the world. And it's terrifying, because I never feel like I'm doing enough, and when I upload my photos I'm like, oh, but I can do so much better, and I never have the time, or I don't have the model, or I don't have something, or something. There's always something wrong. And that's why I was really, really happy to see this photo shoot, like, the first photo shoot that I did in 2018, is it? I think it is. Yeah, like, the first one. The first photo shoot that I did in 2018, and it really did something, even though it wasn't planned, even though it was kind of like a, I don't know, I just need to do a photo shoot now, or I just did it, and I really, really enjoyed it, and I don't know, it's really hard to describe kind of what I'm feeling right now, because it's all very outside the box. This is the box, what you can see on this screen, but my thoughts are right there outside it. See, my hands are there, but you can't see my hands. Oh, you can almost see my hand. There we go. Like, these are my thoughts right outside the box, and I can't explain something that you can't see. And somebody told me that they were intimidated by me, and I just kind of stared at the screen, and I was like, you what? Like, I think it's because I'm either crazy loud or I'm depressingly quiet, which kind of gives two completely different ideas about who I am as a person. And then I'm gonna just give out the most INFJ statement of all time. Nobody knows who I am. I don't even know who I am. I'm such a complex person. Yeah. Every time I do this, I feel like Dan, because it's just like that moment of silence when you can understand the feelings and the vibes emitting from me right now, sitting in my room, to the camera that will then go into the computer, into the editing program, and then onto YouTube. It's just so many vibes that go through so many different pieces of equipment, through so many different locations, even. And just lastly, to finish it off, one last thing. When I was in Poland, my mum told me something that I really needed to hear, because I knew about the thing. I just kind of didn't let it get to me too much, even though it's important. I stopped thinking. Let me explain. I was always a person who would sit down, make theories about something. Sit down, think, or like think, how could I do something? How could I do this? Like, I always had a massive base of theories. I didn't like when somebody gave me the answer to something. I wanted to do it myself, no matter what. And that's why I know that from any other INFJs, they have the same thing. So even if I'm like, oh, I can help you out with this, and they're like, yeah, you can. And then they do it themselves anyway, just because it's an INFJ thing. So when we were talking about something, I asked her like the most stupid question. It was so blatantly obvious, but I asked her the question, and she just kind of looked at me, worried, and said, Gabby, you're not thinking. Just straight up. Gabby, you're not thinking. And I kind of, I just stopped everything I was doing and I was like, mental note, Gabby, you're not thinking. And I knew that. I knew that. I was so aware that I stopped thinking, I stopped theorizing, I stopped making all of these crazy hypotheses that I could then evaluate in my mind. I stopped that. I didn't know why I stopped that. And I had to do something about it. Lately, I've been so inspired by... I'm just going to throw out like a couple things. Kerry, Angel, Confronter, The End of the Fucking World, and oh, there's one more thing that was really inspiring to me. Oh, just like Asian culture, because it kind of, like, the language part really inspires me. I don't know, languages just inspire me. It's a thing. And like with The End of the Fucking World, just movies in general and shows and cinematography inspires me, and new photography as well, that's also a thing. Shush. I've been so inspired in this past couple of weeks that I'm really, really hoping that, you know, I can get something out of it that I can go back into that kind of thinking self without going into the mental self. Because, you know, I like being happy, obviously. I think that's a normal statement right there. But it's not always that easy, and it always makes me sad when people who don't necessarily see happiness in life, you know, they tell me about that. They're like, yeah, I don't really see the point. Zaraz! Jutro! O kurka wodna! Ojejciu! Yeah. Point is, I'm happy. I'm trying to be. And if you're ever sad, or if you know someone who's sad, whatever it is, help them out. Because it's really not fun. I'm really grateful that now when I'm sad, I don't feel as alone as I always did, because I know that I have people I can literally go up and talk to, and previous times when I would go up to people and talk to them, they would just cut me. That's the thing. It's, you know, no happy person wants sadness in their life, and I think that the only people, it's really depressing, Jesus Christ, the only people who understand sad people are the other sad people. It's like saying that a good psychiatrist can only be as mental as their patients, plural, Gary, thank you. Point is, be happy. Be happy or be dead. A quote from 12-year-old Gabby from Gabby's old YouTube channel. Please don't watch Gabby's old YouTube channel. Yeah. Oh, also, a message to my little brother, if he's watching this. Study. Go study, because you're going to die soon. And then you're going to be like, well, that was quick. study. If you need anything, ask me. I'm your big sister for a reason. Love you. Anyway. I'm happy. So you better be happy. Work hard. Play hard. Rest. Yeah. That's essentially how it goes. Work hard, play hard, rest. Okay, don't play too hard, because if you play too hard, then resting is going to be difficult. But work hard, play reasonably, and rest. Be happy or be dead. But, yeah, responsible. Gabby's just the mum of the universe. I'm like, come on, people, I want you all to be very happy and... Yeah. Soon, when I have money, I'm going to buy people food all the time. Literally, that's just my goal, to feed people. Anywho, my hair is just going crazier and crazier with the minute. But look at this, your hair. Oh, so cute. So fluffy, because I had it in braids for like 2 days. Oh, yikes. Oh my god, okay, my camera is dying now. So, I love you. See you soon. And be happy. Be happy, guys. I love you. And literally just take care of yourselves. Because the future is now. The past is also now. Present, funnily enough, is also now. However, the present is also going to be in the future. And the present was in the past. Because that's how tenses work. I love you. Have fun, take care of yourself, and eat stuff. Rest.